working in the lab late one night, when my eyes beheld an eerie sight. For my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
Hey, what's going on? Dr. Gonzo Boogie here again, back for another update video. This is going to be just a horror update. I have some cool Blu-rays and a couple nice little stack of DVDs, so I got some awesome stuff to show you guys. I'm excited about that. But also, you might notice the background is a little different here. I actually just recently picked up another one of these big DVD shelves, and I got it last night, and it was a pain in the ass. I spent 2-3 hours cleaning up my room and rearranging my stuff just so I can fit the shelf in. And then I had to build the shelf. And then once I built it and got it fit in, I was spending hours last night trying to reorganize this stuff. And it's crazy. So right now you guys can't see, but next to me is a stack of almost all my VHS tapes. So there's about, like, 60, 80 VHS tapes just stacked on the floor right next to me. I have some of my tapes on my shelf, but most of my tapes are still stacked on my floor. So I'm hoping to get all this done as soon as I can. And once I have it all set up, I'm going to try to see if I can borrow my friend's camera again, which I shot a DVD collection overview with that before, and I'll try to maybe shoot another video where I go through my collection and show you guys the stuff I have, because since I got this new shelf, which was yesterday, I've been reorganizing and changing all my stuff around and everything, so my collection looks a lot different now than it used to. So I'm real excited about that, but I've been really busy doing that. But I figured I had a little bit of extra time today before I went into work, so I figured I'd try to get an update up for you guys, especially since it's the beginning of October, and I'm still pumped about horror movies and pumped about Halloween time. So, just going to start off and show you guys what I picked up for Blu-rays. I only picked up a couple, but these were Hammer ones that had just recently been put out, and I'm trying to pick them all up right now. I picked up Dracula Has Risen from the Grave and Taste the Blood of Dracula, and Warner Brothers put out some of their Hammer movies on Blu-ray, and I already have their DVD releases of these, but I've been wanting to upgrade all my Hammer movies to Blu-ray, so I was really happy that these came out, and they were stocked at my FYE. Each one of these had like 10 copies of each one. So I picked these two up, but I plan on heading up there again this weekend. And they also have the Mummy one and the Frankenstein Must Be Destroyed one, so I was probably going to pick one of those up this weekend. So I'll be getting another one of these soon, too. They also put out a pack that comes with all four of the separate releases on a pack put together. It's like a small little DVD pack thing, and I would love to get that, too, but actually I love these movie covers so much. I would say the Warner Brothers Hammer releases are some of my favorite Hammer releases in my collection, and I love the way that they use the original movie posters and the way they look so much that I actually just want to get all these separate. Even if I do end up buying the boxed set version of this, I'm still really happy to get these separate. I just think they're really nice looking Blu-rays, and this one I actually haven't even opened yet. Right now they have these at FYE for $16.99, which really isn't too bad of a price compared to what they're going for on Amazon right now, which is about $13-14, so, and then you're paying for shipping, so really this isn't too bad of a deal. And I'll be definitely getting the other two released, which was the Mummy one and Frankenstein Must Be Destroyed, so those will probably be in my next update video. Alright, and I picked up another Hammer thing too. This was a set put out by Mill Creek with some Hammer films on it. And I actually already have a Hammer set that came with most of these. It's one, I think it's from like Columbia Pictures or Paramount. I think it's Columbia, I can't remember though. But that set had already had the two faces of Dr. Jekyll, Scream of Fear, the Gorgon, and the Curse of the Mummy's Tomb on it. So I already have four of these movies, but the fifth movie on this pack, Stop Me Before I Kill, I actually don't have on anything right now. It's either that one or Scream of Fear. One of those two I didn't have yet. So I picked this pack up just for that. It was brand new on sale at FYE for $7, so I figured $7 for a Hammer movie I don't have is a good deal, even though I already had the other four films on this pack. But it's a really nice looking set too, and I like some of the sets that Mill Creek's been putting out, so I also picked out their Boris Karloff set, which this is a really, really cool set. I actually didn't have any of these Boris Karloff movies on DVD anymore. At one time I did have a set that had some of these on it, but that was a while ago when I had that set. So it was really nice to check some of these out again and pick up this set. This one was a little bit pricier. It was $10, brand new at FYE, but still not too bad of a deal. And this comes with The Black Room, The Man They Could Not Hang, The Man with Nine Lives, Before I Hang, The Devil Commands, and The Boogeyman Will Get You. Which some of these I've seen and some that I've never seen. And I'd say my favorite one on this pack is probably The Man They Could Not Hang. That is probably one of my all-time favorite Boris Karloff movies. Just a quick review on that movie. Boris Karloff's like the scientist guy who is working on bringing people back to life using this technique where he like freezes the body and then thaws it a certain way, and that somehow brings the corpse back to life. It's very, you know, 60s sci-fi mumbo jumbo, but what happens is he freezes this guy to death, and he's about to bring him back to life, and then the cops come in, and he's never able to bring this guy back to life, so he ends up going to jail and getting hung for killing this guy. And so Boris Karloff's assistant actually brings Boris Karloff back to life using the technique they have, and then Boris Karloff takes revenge on all the people who sent him to jail and sent him to hang. And it's just such a cool story idea, but it gets even cooler because Boris Karloff's character invites all these people to this one house, and he has the house locked down, kind of House on Haunted Hill style, where there's like electric gates and everything, you can't get out. And one by one, these people start dying off like every 15 minutes. And it's a really, really interesting and fun Boris Karloff movie. I'd say this pack is worth picking up alone just for that one movie. Really, really great and fun Boris Karloff movie. The Man They Could Not Hang. Really good stuff. I got some more classic monster stuff here. This is the Wolfman Legacy set. And in my last update video, I mentioned that I needed a couple more of the Legacy sets. I needed the Wolfman one and the Invisible Man one. And then so now I have all of them except the Invisible Man Legacy set. But I actually had most of the films on this set already. But the one movie that I did not have on DVD was Frankenstein Meets the Wolfman, which is one of my favorite Universal Monster movies of all time. It was one of the first ones I really remember watching when I was younger. So I felt like I needed to get this one on DVD, so I picked up the Wolfman set to get that one. So now I have basically all of the Universal Monster movies on DVD, except the four Invisible Man sequels, which are on the Legacy set, and I plan to pick that one up soon. If I don't get it for Halloween, I'll definitely try to get that one for like Christmas or something like that. But the Wolfman Legacy pack, and this is a good set. In case you guys don't know, it comes with the Wolfman, Frankenstein Meets the Wolfman, House of Frankenstein, House of Dracula, Abbott and Costello Meet Frankenstein, Werewolf of London, and She-Wolf of London. So not only does this pack come with all of the werewolf movies that were on the older Legacy set, but it also comes with a few more, like Abbott and Costello Meet Frankenstein and House of Dracula and House of Frankenstein, some of the other Universal Monster movies that feature Lon Chaney Jr. as the Wolfman. So these newer Legacy sets are really cool how they really included every movie with that monster in the set. Really nice how they did that. Alright, next up I have a couple more Roger Corman things that I added to my collection. And first off here is part of the Cult Classics series put out by Shout Factory, which one of these days, just like all of the Scream Factory horror releases, I plan on, you know, I would love to buy them all. And same goes for these Shout Factory Roger Corman Cult Classics releases. One day I would love to have all these in my collection, mainly just the sci-fi horror ones. But still, I would love to get all of them because Roger Corman is just one of my favorite director, producer, writer, whatever you want to call him. He's just great. This was really good, Galaxy of Terror. This had Sid Haig in it. It also had Robert Englund in it. And, yeah, this was kind of like an Alien ripoff with a little bit of Star Wars put, you know, a little bit of ripoff Star Wars ideas thrown in, too. So, basically just one of the like, all the other sci-fi movies Roger Corman was tossing out towards the late 70s and early 80s. Definitely has the same vibe as that. I thought this was pretty fun, even though I did start to get a little bored towards the end. These Roger Corman movies I love, but I do find that sometimes I get a little bored watching them, but I always, you know, always love these movies either way. This one, I would say, only got a little boring towards the end, but other than that, it was really fun. And you gotta love the cover artwork on this. Probably one of the coolest things about it. And just like the other Scream Factory and Shout Factory releases, it has some alternative artwork inside and a nice little booklet thing, which I love how a lot of these Roger Corman releases have a little booklet that comes with them. So really cool stuff here. And then I actually picked this up, which is another Scream Factory Roger Corman release, but this is almost looks like a budget, like, public domain pack that you would buy at, like, a dollar store at Walmart for, like, a couple bucks. But I was looking up Roger Corman Scream Factories on Amazon, and I came across this. And this is just a tin that has one of the packs that you can get in a normal case like that, but they put it in this tin. And because it's in this, like, shitty tin thing, it was really discounted a lot. So I was able to pick this one up for basically $5 brand new, including shipping. So I thought that was a good deal to get a few more Roger Corman movies. Even though I do think the tin case is a little bit goofy, and I've never been the biggest fan of these tin case releases, I just thought it was a good way to get a couple more Roger Corman movies for a really good price. And this one comes with Attack of the Crab Monster. Trying to get the pictures on here. War of the Satellites. And Not of This Earth, which I've never seen any of those, but I've heard of all three, so I'm looking forward to seeing those ones for the first time. And this is a cool pack because it comes with some of his earlier works. On a lot of those other Scream Factory packs, you get Shout Factory packs, you get a lot of the movies he put out in the 70s and 80s, and these ones are actually from the late 50s, so I'm just glad to add on to some of my, you know, like, earlier Roger Corman works, because I don't have too many of his earlier films on DVD right now. So, I mean, an iffy packaging on this one, but all around the DVDs and the movies it comes with, it's a really good deal for this price. I'll show you guys what the inside of this looks like. Not my favorite way they have this set up, but the discs are kind of just put in there like this, and they're actually a little tough to get out. There is some space in between them, so they're not exactly on top of each other. But still, I'm a little iffy about how they have the discs in here. But other than that, pretty decent set for a good price. Can't go wrong with some new Roger Corman stuff. Alright, and then last up for this video, I picked up another like budgety pack. And this is from Diamond Entertainment, and this is a Killers collection. It comes with 5 films on 2 DVDs. This comes with The Sadist, The Killing Kind, House by the Cemetery, which is a classic, and I have the Anchor Bay Director's Cut DVD of that. Silent Night, Bloody Night, which is a Christmas horror movie I've never seen. If that's any good, let me know in the comments, guys, if that one's worth checking out. And Don't Look in the Basement. So I picked this one up, actually, because I got this brand new off the computer, again, for like $5, including shipping and everything. And the main reason I picked this up was because probably about a month or two ago, I was in a thrift store, and I came across this zombie collection released by the same company. And this comes with Night of the Living Dead, The Night Evelyn Came Out of the Grave, Terror Creatures from the Grave, Messiah of Evil, and The Snake People. And for some reason, I just really liked this set. It has like a cheesy drawing on it, but it's actually not too bad. I mean, someone had to take time out of their life to draw that and color it, and it's actually not too bad of a picture. And the movies it came with, I liked the random variety. You know, I was surprised that, like, White Zombie wasn't thrown on this, which I would have been glad if it was, but I kind of liked the random variety of the movies that were on the pack, and I just liked the way the pack was set up in general. For some reason, it just appealed to me. So when I saw this one going on eBay for such a cheap price, brand new, I picked it up kind of just for fun. And I figure every once in a while, if I see one of these packs floating around on eBay or at a thrift store, I'm going to pick them up, because I did check on the computer, and Diamond Entertainment put out a good amount of these packs. I would say probably around like 6 or 8 of them. I know that they have like a ghost one and a sci-fi pack. So if you guys have any of these packs and you don't care about them and you want to get rid of them, let me know in the comments and maybe we can make some sort of deal, because right now these are actually something that I want to collect, and these are just like cheapo dollar store public domain packs. So, you know, if you guys see any of these for a cheap price, you know, or you have any, like I said, maybe we make some sort of deal, because right now I sort of want to collect them all. But other than that, just this is... that is what I picked up for this week. Hopefully you guys liked the video, like always. And if you did, definitely leave a comment or give this video a big old thumbs up. And I'll see you guys next time.